for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. What's up, Calm? Today is Friday, April 20th, 2012. I'm Tommy Quickio.
And I'm Simone. Live Future Focus.
So Simone, today's Friday, last day of the week.
And there's a meeting for 6th, 7th, and 8th grade field hockey members, new or old, after school today. So make sure you go.
Yeah, make sure you go to that. Don't want to miss that.
Yeah.
So let's get into the show.
Mm-hmm.
Most people do not know that rocks are complex. However, we have a video on Mr. Rodriguez's 6th grade science class to enlighten you.
Right now, Mr. Rodriguez's 6th grade science classes are learning about rocks and the different types of rocks. To find out more, I visited his 8th period science class. I decided the best way to find out the most I could about rocks was to ask the people who are learning about it, Mr. Rodriguez's students.
Well, igneous rock kind of forms from lava.
Igneous rock is classified according to their origin, texture, and mineral composition.
The longer the igneous rock takes to cool, the bigger the texture.
Whoa! If my calculations are correct, 3/4 of the Earth is made of sedimentary rocks.
Made up of broken bits of other rocks.
Sedimentary rocks form from layers.
Igneous rock is better!
No.
It forms from lava!
No, sedimentary is. It makes up 3/4 of the crust.
No, igneous sounds cooler.
Sedimentary is better.
No, igneous is.
Sedimentary!
Igneous!
Sedimentary!
According to Softpedia.com, the largest stone in the world is in Australia.
Today's KT holiday is National Day of Silence. Some schools do this to prevent bullying someone. According to nctfnet.org, National Day of Silence is a day for some students in the United States to protest against harassment, discrimination, and hate. Hundreds of schools all over America make a pledge to this day to not speak for a whole day to make a stand against bullying. GLESN.org reported that there are bullying prevention programs in almost every middle school and high school in America.
Recently, the MLB season has started and the Marlins have started off as a new team. What team did the Marlins change their name to? Is it A, the Orlando Salmon? Maybe B, the Florida Trout? Possibly C, the Miami Marlins? Or is it D, the Florida Sharks? The leadoff hitter for this team is Jose Reyes. And the answer is C, Miami Marlins. Miami Marlins have picked up 3 prospects who are Heath Bell, Mark Buehler, and Jose Reyes. The logo for their new team is a capital M with a Marlin going through it. According to FistStripes.com, the Marlins are projected to have a win-loss record of 87-75.
Today's job of the day is a social worker. A social worker is a man or woman who someone employed to provide social services, especially those with disadvantages. According to BecomeASocialWorker.com, to become a social worker, one must have the minimum education qualifications needed is a bachelor's degree in social work. According to NASDC.org, the amount of professions a social worker has grown from 30% from 2010.
So I'm here with sports.
Yes, you are. So let's get into that.
So yesterday in sports, our very own New Jersey Devils creamed the Florida Panthers 4-0.
That's great.
Also in hockey, the Washington Capitals defeated last year's Stanley Cup winners, the Boston Bruins.
That's good.
In baseball, the New York Yankees beat the Minnesota Twins 7-6.
That's really good.
And the Baltimore Orioles won over the Chicago White Sox 5-3.
That's good. I'm a big Yankees fan, so
I'm
glad they won.
I'm a big Devils fan, so I was happy.
That's good. See you guys later.
Where is the Love is a song by Black Eyed Peas, which asks America to look into their heart and bring back the love. Rather than hurt and bully people, try loving and caring for each other.
got one world, one world. That's all we got, one world, one world. Something's wrong with it, something's wrong with it, something's wrong with the whole world, world. Yeah, we only got one world, one world. That's all we got, one world.
According to Wikipedia, Where is the Love reached as high as 8th on the Billboard Hot 100 in 2003.
Today's KTV birthday is Louis Napoleon Bonaparte. Louis Napoleon Bonaparte was the first president of the French Republic. He is most known for being really short and rebuilding of Paris. According to Conservapedia.com, he is also famous for modernizing France. He promoted the expansion of railroads and telegraph lines. Louis Napoleon Bonaparte is turning... has his birthday today.
So we have an announcement with Mike and Matt over there.
Yes, let's pass it over to them.
Mm-hmm.
So Matt, do you know what is coming up?
I believe it's Bring Your Child to Work Day.
Yeah, and if you want to go, you have to let Mrs. McAvoy know by Monday the 23rd.
So you have to fill out this form and bring it in. So back to you guys in the studio.
Sure, you bring that in.
Yeah,
that's very important.
Mm-hmm, very.
All right, let's get back into the news.
Mm-hmm.
On this day in history, Phil Jackson broke the record for most wins in a single season as a coach. So let's pass it over to Andrew for more on that.
Mike's on, Andrew's mic.
Thanks, guys. Phil Jackson is known to be one of the best basketball coaches of all time and was inducted into the Hall of Fame today in 2007.
Jackson, can you tell me about your 96 season?
Sure. In 1996, I coached the amazing Chicago Bulls.
I heard that team broke a record. Is that correct?
That is correct. We are the team that had the most wins in a single season, 72. And it turns out we won our 72nd game on this day. It brings back great memories.
Wow, congrats. What was your starting lineup in 1996?
Our starting five was Michael Jordan, Scottie Pippen, Dennis Rodman, Ron Harper, and Luke Longley. It was a great opportunity to coach such great players.
That sounds like a great lineup.
It is set to be the best starting lineup ever.
How many championship rings have you earned over your career?
Well, I earned 2 rings as a player on the Knicks. And as a coach, I have 6 rings with the Bulls and 3 championship rings with the Lakers.
How was it to be able to coach Kobe Bryant?
It's obvious he's a great player coming out of high school, but his only flaw is he needs to learn to pass the ball and share the fame with other superstars on his team.
Jackson has 70 win seasons as a coach, which ties in with Pat Riley for the most all-time.
Before Ms. Sarasa became a teacher, she worked as an NUI corporation as a contract administrator. A contract administrator, like what Ms. Sarasa did, was direct activities concerned with contracts for purpose or sale of equipment, materials, products, or services. A contract administrator also negotiates contracts with customer or bidder. They can also direct sales programs and request or approve amendments to or extend of contracts. Ms. Rasa, she enjoyed this job, but since teaching would give her a better schedule to be with her kids, she became a teacher. A contractor administrator average salary is $75,000.
So Zach, you're here with the weather, so let's pass it over to Zach.
Now, so it's looking very nice out here, so if you take a look at the 4-day forecast, today it's going to be really sunny with a high of 72. To kick off the weekend, there's going to be thunderstorms with a high of 75. On Sunday, it's going to rain with a high of 52. And on Monday, the first day of the NJS, it's going to be rainy with a high of 57. See, it's looking very nice out here, so back to you guys in the studio.
So that's pretty good. Yeah, it's going to be 75 on Sunday. That's pretty good.
All right.
So it's the end of the show, Simone.
It was a good show, but we had some awesome videos today. We had that awesome Where's Love, so.
Yeah, so prep for next week for NJS.
Mm-hmm. Make sure you do that.
So for Simone Squire and the rest of the KTV News team, I'm Tommy Clickio. Have a great day.